Hey yo, it is the Show Light TV and it's your boy Bravo, and today we got a special guest. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
It's good, I'm PM Gamble. I'm with the Show Light TV.
Yes. Thank you so much for being on the show. I really appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? So, how are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
That's right. So where are we at today?
So I just been hanging with some homies, pulled up right now.
That's right. And we in Los Angeles, California, so shout out, you know what I'm saying, everybody out here. I told y'all Show Life TV was gonna be in Cali and we here. So now I see that you just dropped your new music video, Froze. Let's talk about that. How did that come along? You know, saying how was the process? Cause I love the video. Video dope as hell. So what was the process with that?
So look, Froze. I dropped Froze like 2021. Mm-hmm. I dropped Froze 2021. We initially did a video for Froze, right? And some bullshit happened. So like, I just like forgot about the whole video. But then like, I met Swavy. Swavy like the open mic, and she was fucking with Froze. And, you know, like we tapped in and everything. Like months later, like we ended up like going to Big Bear and shooting something, and then going back again.
Right.
And then getting it done.
So it was in Big Bear.
Yeah, it was in Big Bear.
Oh, cool! I love it. So who produced the beat? Like who was the producer for the beat?
So I went on YouTube, okay, and found a producer named Strizzy. Mm-hmm. So yeah, he produced the beat.
Strizzy bring that fire. I like that. Okay. So was this just a single, or is this going towards a project or anything like that?
No, that was my first song, really. Like my first real song.
Okay. So this is your first real song that you put out just completely?
Nah, like this was my first song I put out, but like, okay, it was my first song like I was like putting like my actual emotion into it.
Okay. And what made you kind of really kind of lock down and focus on this? Because I know it's like a gateway from not taking it seriously to taking it seriously, you know?
Sure, like honestly, I didn't like what do you mean like taking it seriously?
Like when you really want to like jump in the studio and really record these songs, you know what I'm saying?
Well, what happened with Froze was I was going through like a breakup.
Okay. And then, all right. Give me the juice.
It was like summer. I was going through a breakup. It was summer. I was in the crib. Uh-huh. And then like I was already making music, like, and I heard a beat. Uh-huh. And you know, like I just put like my emotion into that joint.
Awesome.
And then as soon as I recorded, I went like, I have a studio across my house. It's called Dave D Studios.
Okay.
So like I walked over there, mm-hmm, and like recorded Froze, mm-hmm, really. And then, yeah, I dropped it like right not too long ago, like after I recorded it.
Okay. So let me ask you a question. What's your music? What do you feel like you're putting out to the public? Like the image that you're putting out to the public?
Really just emotion. Mm-hmm. Like honestly, everything I'm trying to put out is just like a piece of me.
Yeah.
Really, like, say I'm going through like a breakup, or say like something happened in my life, or something that, like, because honestly, growing up, I listened to like a lot of music to like help me get through a lot of stuff.
Yes.
So, like, me being an artist, like, I want to be an artist that, like, I connected to, like, growing up type shit.
I understand. So, give me three of your inspirations in this music industry. Now let's do this. Let's do inspiration with music and inspiration with just your life. You know, your family, your friends, and then give me some with your artists.
Okay, so my artist, I could go with Cole.
Cole. Okay.
Old school, Lauryn Hill. Mm-hmm. Lauryn Hill. And then one more. K-Dot.
All right, shout out K-Dot. All right, okay. And so, with the inspiration with the family, when I ask this question, I usually, you know what I'm saying, try to, people that you know you can run to when situations are hard, you know?
So I can say, my pops, my uncle, my pops, I grew up in Riverside. Okay. My pops stayed in San Bernardino. So, like, I stayed with my grandparents and my moms. But, like, when I lived with my pops, I went to the Dino. And then my uncle, like, my whole family stays out in L.A.
Okay.
So, like, I come out here most of the time. And it was my uncle, like, I could talk to him about a lot. My grandma. R.I.P. She recently passed.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I completely understand. But you know, she watching. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So you hold it down. Yeah. All right. So let me ask you a question about yourself. What's a real nigga to you?
Randy.
Yeah. What's the definition of a real nigga to you?
Somebody who stand on their word. Mm-hmm. Somebody who stand on their word.
Yeah.
And somebody who just takes care of their business. Mm-hmm. For real, takes care of their people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I usually ask these questions about, like, knowledge with you being in this industry right now. The things that you know now, I don't know how far you've been, but the things that you know now, if you can go back in time, what would you tell yourself?
Sure. I'll tell myself just, like, keep pushing, just keep going, like, through all the bullshit. You feel me? It's going to be a lot of, like, things that's going to, like, stop certain shit, but you just gotta keep going. Cause if you don't keep going, you feel me? You know, sometimes like I like didn't keep my word on that shit. So you feel me? Like I'm still like, you feel me, getting on that path to like staying consistent.
So a big thing is consistency, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure, you gotta keep going.
Right, and that's the thing that a lot of artists don't understand. And it's funny that you say that, is being consistent and working hard. You know, so what is like, what are your steps to stay consistent and stay,
I produce now, so like one thing, so when I started making music, I was hopping on YouTube beats.
Okay.
And then I realized I wanted to like make craft songs, you feel me? Like, I like Kendrick's production, mm-hmm. like on a lot of his songs. I like, you know, who else I like? I like Pharrell, you feel me? I like music, you feel me? So like, when I first started making music, it was, I love music, mm-hmm. but like, I didn't know how to produce, I didn't know how to like, craft what I had in my head.
Yes.
So like, when I started like, learning how to do that, that's like, that was everything. So right. like, I'm working on a project right now, like, I just finished all the beats, so okay. I'm about to.
And what's the name of that project?
My Cloudy Remedy.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have a date for it that you want to drop it, or is it just kind of like, you know?
Sure, like, I'm working, like, it should be done this month. Okay. And then, like, my birthday, like, I dropped my first project. It was called Cloudy. I dropped on my birthday.
Mm.
So, it's June 21st.
And how many songs were on that project?
It was 5 songs.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. You felt good about that, huh?
Yeah, that's right.
Cloudy. Okay, were there any special features on that one, or is it just
kind of... That was just me. Like, that was me just... That was another version of just, I just put my feelings in that shit, because that was, like, another version of Froze just keeping that shit going, really.
I understand. So, this industry is crazy, you know what I'm saying, and it goes up and down. And you just being an artist, I know you kind of can look at it from a fan, and being an artist is a job now to you, you know? So how do you feel about the music industry in 2024 right now? Like, how do you feel about that?
Right now, I'm listening to old school. So I like, it's like,
okay, right, so you're a soul. Okay, you with the soul. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, I understand. I respect it.
I listen to old school.
Mm-hmm.
But like, the industry right now, I can't say too much about like,
no, you can't. That's what we're here for.
Shit.
Express yourself.
Well, yeah. Honestly, I feel like more people need to like get closer to like to themselves. Really, people need to get closer to themselves and expressing their real, like, their true feelings. Cause I feel like a lot of people just copy what the next man is doing for, they don't really know themselves and shit. So like, you gotta like really know yourself and like really know yourself and not. You feel me?
Yeah. So you feel like a lot of these artists aren't being original anymore?
Music's easy to make now. Yeah. And I'm like, I'm not saying like, it's easy to like hear somebody sing and just, you know, like, it's a lot of that. So it's just, a lot of people need to just, what, the whole industry, really, man, I don't, like, you feel me, I don't.
It's up and down.
Yeah, it's up and down, but I like old school, so like that's why I can tell you about like the old school shit, but like right now,
well,
the new school shit.
Give me one of your old school artists.
Nas, Ice Cube, shit. I like damn, who is shit? I like Outkast.
Okay.
So like Andre 3000,
okay.
The group itself.
Okay.
Slick Rick, like I go back. You feel me?
Well, Let me ask you a couple questions then with this one then. If you could give me an artist that from back in the day that you would think could start their career over now and still be as successful back then, if I'm saying that right.
Nas, for sure.
Like, Nas could start his career over now and still be as successful back then as he is?
Nas. Man, Nas is all right.
Okay,
yeah, for sure.
Okay. Give me another one.
Let's see.
Give me an R&B singer. We did rap.
R&B singer,
yeah,
okay.
Let me see.
Damn, old school? But like...
Yeah, we go old school.
Well, me personally, I would listen to some Teddy
Pendergrass. Teddy P?
Yeah, Teddy P.
Yeah, okay.
Like, that's... Because I like old school, the Icy Brothers.
Okay.
You feel me?
Okay. I was thinking it would be a little different now because there's no real love R&B music that they were making back in the day. Like,
shit.
Ron Isley is singing about shooting a female and, you know what I'm saying, all kind of shit, taking hoes and all that now. Okay. So, what was your favorite music video at that time, like an old school music video? Mine was like Billie Jean.
Oh yeah, mine was Smooth Criminal.
Smooth
Criminal, yeah, that was cold.
Okay.
Smooth Criminal, that shit.
Smooth Criminal, when he leaned over it?
Yeah, nah, when he threw that coin into the shit, that shit was cold. Like, I like all the Michael Jackson Beat It, all that, like all types, every Michael Jackson, Michael Jackson catalog, mm-hmm. video, you feel me? Tapped in with that.
Okay. All right, so let's get back into the music, you know what I'm saying? Is there any new projects after this that you feel like you want to get into, or any new, you know, ventures that you want to get into?
I'm playing the guitar right now, so like I'm expanding my genres. So like I make all types of music, but like, I wanted to be in a band. Like, when I was growing up and shit, like, I listened to everything.
Mm-hmm.
My pops, he was, put me on, like, old school hip-hop. My mom's, like, kind of, like, listened to, like, rock and shit, too. Like, my mom's from Nigeria and shit.
Mm.
But, like, she be listening to, like, rock. Like, she be listening to rock and shit. So, I just, like, picked up on, like, everything. Mm. So, I like rock, too.
Okay.
Like, so I'm learning how to play the guitar and everything, and like integrate the guitar in my like production and everything.
Okay.
Like this new project, you finna hear that like, for sure.
Okay. So we want to make sure that when you do get the project done, that the people that's watching this, the fans, can make sure to link in with you, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, how would they be able to contact you or get in, you know, get in with you?
So my Instagram is PM Gamble, and like everything. For me, it's PM Gamble. I'm on everything, so.
Okay.
Yeah, I got a show actually this Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Well, what day? Because we don't want to look back a year from now.
Like, yeah, this Saturday, April 6, 2024.
Okay. And where at?
The Basement, Pomona.
Okay, shout out to The Basement. I've been down there before. Okay, that's dope. Well, do you want to give any shout outs to anyone? You know what I'm saying? Or
Shout out, wait, like, what you mean?
Just give shout out to anybody.
Like, okay. Mm-hmm. Shout out Cal, for putting together the show. Shout out Swavy for, the video and everything, for real. And shout out, again, shout out everybody. Mm-hmm. Shout out, K-4-4-4 Cam, you feel me?
Yes,
shout out everybody, for real.
Yeah. We got four next. on this motherfucker. Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? So you already know what's going down. So like TV being in the building, man. So I want to thank you so much. Thank you so much for being on the show. We want to make sure that we lock you in. So this is what I usually do. I do story time with the artists. You know, I know you kind of got a lot going on, but I usually sit you down in front of the camera. I don't ask any questions. I just let you tell the story about something that happened in your life, learning experience, a funny experience, or something like that. So next time I catch you, can we do that?
Okay, for sure.
Say less. Well, it's the Show Life TV, and it's your boy Bravo, and we about this motherfucker.
All right.
It is. Yeah.